with Mark Harrell of BadX Toolworks. Mark, go ahead and introduce yourself to the viewers.
Hi, as Sean said, I'm Mark Harrell, owner of BadX Toolworks. Well, we make the world's best backsaw. We can size your handle to fit. What sets us apart from that, we combine form and function at the highest possible level. A saw has to cut better than anything else, that's a given. All right, we do so by hammer setting our teeth, by helping the customer fully realize exactly what kind of saw it is they want, and in fact what they need based on their woodworking style. We take the time to make sure that we understand that so we can recommend the best saw for them, the best type of saw. And so far as the sharpening goes, we hammer set the tooth line, which is a precision way of setting that's incredibly precise. And all teeth are sharpened to joint. Anybody can sharpen a saw, but not everybody can sharpen to joint. We sharpen our saws to joint because we do the simple things incredibly well. We discipline ourselves to do that. Part of that discipline comes from the military because this is a veteran-owned business that hires veterans. So there's that lingua franca in the shot that it's pretty cut and dried what the standard is, and it's an incredibly high standard. I know that kind of sounds like blue sky, but that's why our saws cut like they're on rails. You will not find a better saw.
So one last question. If you had to buy either a robot vacuum or a BadX saw, what would you buy?
I'd buy the robot vacuum because my floor is covered in sawdust from everybody that's been buying our saws.
All right, I think that answers the question. Thank you, Mark.
All right, Sean.
I'm here with John Switzer of Black Bear Forge. John, tell us what you do.
I'm a small blacksmith shop, one-person shop in Beulah, Colorado, and I specialize in hardware and unique tools for woodworkers.
Great. Can you show us some of your wares?
Absolutely. Some of the hardware items I make a wide variety of hinges. They're all hand-forged. Some various chest handles. And then I also do some tools, everything from wood chisels and axes. And this is a wing compass or divider. And doing some adzes and some draw knives.
You see those. Do you have anything for benches?
Benches, yes. I have some holdfasts. And this is a small bench. But fast is a loose fit, mm-hmm. But when you smack it with a mallet, you lift the whole bench off the ground, and you can smack it again to
very nice.
To let it go.
Very nice.
Hamilton Woodworks Incorporated. It's hamiltontools.com. This is my 4-inch cherry marking gauge. It's one of my top sellers. It features a cutter blade instead of a pin, and I like the blade more than the pin because of the layout line that I get. It's sharp, crisp. It's a clean line. There's no jagged tear out. It's the curved blade. It's a fingernail grind that gives you, it keeps the fence tight against the workpiece. So you don't have, it won't track to the grain. It cuts as well with the grain as it does across it. It's a very comfortable gauge to use. I do make them in 4- and 6-inch versions. This is the 6-inch. It's just bigger. It's a little more comfortable in guys' hands. It's got bigger hands. I make them in a variety of species. Just about anything you can come up with, I'll make it out of. I do have a marking knife. hope to have out possibly next year, be my future product to go along with the gauge.
Jeff, when these cutters are dull, how do you go about sharpening them?
Well, the best way to do that is to take the blade and just flatten the back again, just on your finest stone, just flatten the back. And when you do that, you're gonna roll just a very tiny burr over the tip. So take that, and what I use is a pair of locking needle-nose pliers, and then I just strop the front on a leather strop with some honing compound, and you're gonna go back to business.